From Edinburgh, here's Harry.
The floral tributes came from all over the country, but a group of Leeds fans summed up what Revy meant to the club.
Speaking for me and for the rest of the lads, I think he gave most of us probably a very happy childhood. With the team he built, well, we all know what it was. Probably best in Europe, and we're very unlikely to see a team like that again.
It's obviously deeply affected you, this, hasn't it?
Oh, it's like losing part of your family.
As a small group of fans who'd travelled up from Leeds waited outside, the Reverend Leslie Barb paid his own tribute. The service was held at Warriston Crematorium in Edinburgh, about 25 miles from Don Revy's adopted Scottish home in Kinross. Among the mourners, some of the most well-known names and faces in football from the 60s and 70s, members of the Leeds United team, which Revy forged into one of the best sides in Europe. Players who'd followed Revy into the manager's chair at Elland Road, but never quite recreated the glory years. Tributes from friends and colleagues flowed freely.
Don Revy built a great team, and he had a special relationship with all the players, I think, and they were a special group, and certainly look back on it fondly.
He was a very warm, friendly man who had a great family himself and encouraged the family atmosphere in a football club, which is very difficult. And he produced some tremendous players who carried on, a lot of them in football, to do good things. And that came out of the family type of club that he had.
I think for two or three years at Leeds United, he probably produced sides as good as anywhere in the world up to that point. I've got great affection for him, and I'm just so sad that the end was such a painful one for him and came so devastatingly early. I've got great memories of Don Revy, and he'll go down, I think, as one of our great football managers.
Former England skipper under Revy, Kevin Keegan, flew in specially from Spain.
You know, I walked out on him as an England player, and he phoned me up and told me to come back. He's like a father to me, you know, and he saved my England career. He was a great manager. I just think he was very unfortunate that we just didn't have any good players. As simple as that. If the players had been good enough, he would have probably been as great a success as Alf Ramsey.
When the cortege arrived, Revy's widow, Elsie, had to be helped into the chapel. Revy's motto had been keep fighting. He fought to the end against the incurable muscle-wasting motor neurone disease. He was just 61.
The Leeds United family, as it was known, like Billy Bremner, had obviously special association with him. But so too did Laurie McMenemy, the former Southampton and Sunderland manager.
As far as football is concerned, he helped me tremendously and a lot of other young managers starting off. He always made you feel as if you were first division, even though you were managing in the fourth at the time. And he was always first on the telephone with any advice, especially if you weren't doing too well.
There's no doubt that the boss would have been happy with the send-off he received from the team that won every honour for Leeds United. I can well remember the first time I met Don Revy. I was a rather nervous cub reporter with Radio Leeds, and to be honest, the first interview I did with him wasn't very good. At the end of it, he said, "I'll tell you what, lad, let's do it again." I soon learned that Don Revy was more than a manager. He was a person who cared very deeply for his players. Today, of course, they've respected him by all reassembling together. All the great team players are there. But I reckon he would have had extra pleasure in two of those members today, Alan Clark and Mick Jones, because the greatest memory of Leeds United for me was back in the FA Centenary Final in 1972. You remember it, don't you? Jones down the right, the cross comes over, Alan Clark's there. Leeds beat Arsenal 1-0. A fitting tribute to one of the greatest managers this country has ever had.